Namaskar. I am Dr. Smita Pankaj Naram. I am wife of Dr. Pankaj Naram.
And my name is Krishna Pankaj Naram. I am the son of Dr. Naram. And today, we have a news for you.
Friends, 2 days ago, my husband Dr. Pankaj Naram was coming back from Dubai. And as soon as he sat in the flight, he just called us and we had such a jovial, laughing phone conversation. He spoke to me, he spoke to him. He also spoke to Jack Canfield, who is right now, you know, taking treatment. And it was so wonderful. And after 2 hours, he lands to Mumbai airport. He goes to immigration area and he collapses. And they just moved him to the hospital somewhere. We got a phone call and we rushed to this hospital. I couldn't believe anything wrong can happen to him, actually. Till I reached there, because he is so vibrant, full of energy. He is so healthy looking. And he was laughing with us. There was no signs of anything, actually. We reached there. And doctor says that his heartbeat, his pulse is completely gone for last 1 hour. We gave CPR, we gave all the emergency treatments, but it's not coming back. I touched his head, I touched his pulse. There was no pulse to be felt. I felt everything was becoming cold. I still couldn't believe. I told the doctor, maybe we can do again CPR, we do something that he comes back. But the doctor says, not possible. And I've seen actually him helping people coming out of coma, helping people in emergency heart attack situations where there was a patient in the clinic actually in front of me who just while sitting in the waiting area got a heart attack, severe, massive heart attack, was perspiring, completely collapsed. He just instantly gave only few things, few herbs, some home remedy, and this patient just came out. And then he said, okay, now you go and do all the checkups and whatever is necessary, and then take Ayurveda so that you will have a long lasting real health. So I started thinking, maybe there is something from ancient secret which can bring him back. But I realized once prana was gone, it cannot come back. And we were like literally not believing what's happened. I cried for hours and hours and hours, and I couldn't believe this. We were both under shock, literally under shock. And after some hours, I thought it is divine choice. He was an angel, and possibly the angels wanted him to come back home. We just accepted that.
It was about 12:10 when I got this news, and I got a call actually by his personal assistant, and he said that he was in the immigration coming back from Dubai and they've taken Papa to the hospital. I said, but can't you help him? You have been with him since 15 years. He says they're not allowing me inside. There's no way to go and he's alone. I wish someone was there, because I have also seen these ancient healing secrets heal anybody so deeply that life is never like before it was. Life is a new life, a new energy they get. And this is how it happened with Papa. I could not accept this.
Yeah, and we have been working since 1987 together. And I have seen him actually working selflessly, literally selflessly. He doesn't care for his food when he's working in the clinic. He doesn't care for his sleep. He can work, go on and on till the clients are there, the patients are there, and as much as he can help, he just wants to do it. So he just worked and worked without thinking of anything, not of himself, not his family. He's completely, unconditionally, selflessly helping humanity. And I saw him doing it so much that this mission of him to help humanity literally touched our heart. And I thought, and we felt literally very inspired to take it forward and devote our life to spread these ancient secrets for the benefit of humanity, in fact. And I also actually remembered that when we wanted to have a baby, because I wanted to literally have a baby very strongly, you know, being a female, it's a natural urge. He was so afraid. He thought that I can't take care of my son or whoever is my baby, because I'm so busy and completely devoted to this world, that he was afraid. And one day, you know, after 16 years of avoiding, I just got pregnant and I got this beautiful boy. And you will not believe me, he trained him so well. Just by age 6, my son was sitting on his lap, looking at the pulse. He didn't even know what he's doing, but his subconscious mind didn't know. And he was grabbing all these wisdoms already from a very young age of 1 or 2 years until today.
It's something shocking that just a month ago, and you would be shocked to hear this. I'm sure mommy has all those books, but whatever books papa's master had given him, anything that he had ever had, some basic, essential, powerful principles and secrets of how we can heal anybody deeper. Just a month ago, papa said, these are the last ones that I want to give you. That's it. This is everything that I ever have, everything that you ever need. Don't go anywhere else. Just have this and you will save lives. And I said, papa, but are you sure? Like, am I ready? He said, no, this is just, keep it with you. Start reading it. You are ready. You don't know it that you are ready. And now I realize that he was actually training me since day one of my life. Anytime I wanted to go meet papa, I had to actually be in the clinic, see these many pulses, and then we would celebrate together. It was a miracle. In fact, you know, we were both really sad and upset and in tears, broken, devastated. But I just remembered what papa would always say. He said that once his head was hurt and his eye almost, he almost lost his eye. And at that time, blood was flowing like crazy. Eyes had blood in it, face had blood in it, it was dripping down on the floor. And we were shocked, we were afraid what's gonna happen. And even then, we just cleaned it up. And he says, okay, now let me get back. There are people waiting for me. One lady is in coma, I'm getting her call. So he went back on his call. I said, papa, wait, you can't even see properly from this eye. He said, I know I can't see, but I can speak properly. I can hear properly. We just have a call. And so he kept the call and he said, Krishna, look, no matter what, the show must go on. Never stop. His life, his work, his patience and his work was his God. So today, we want to invite you from our heart, because Papa said that the show must go on no matter what. It's not a prayer meeting just, but we have organized a celebration of his life here on earth with us. And we invite you from our heart to this powerful meeting at the given address.
In Mumbai. And also this will be actually available live on the links which is there in the comments below. So do join us and pray for this legendary life, the legendary healer on this planet, so that we pray that he rest in peace with the angels where he is gone. I invite you.
Yes.
And we both love you.
We love you. Like Dr. Naram said, after every video, he would say, Namaskar, I love you all. And to everybody he met, he said, Namaskar, I love you. You are my brother, you are my sister, you are my child. You are like my father, like my mother. You are all. we strongly believe our extended family, and if you are anywhere in Mumbai, in India, we invite you to celebrate his life. And if you're at home, you can connect on this live video from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. on Indian Standard Time and really experience his life, his deeper healing secrets, and light a candle. We can pray for his soul, a man through whom God worked, a legendary master healer, a tribute to his life. We love you all.
We love you all.
And namaskar.
Namaskar.